Just before we get to a person of interest this morning, who's the chairperson of the County Assembly's Forum, Abdinur, let's take this story where County Assembly's Forum has abandoned Council of Governors and Code referendum and has set a roadmap for their own referendum. The members of the County Assemblies have now moved to chart their own destiny by forming their own technical committee. The MCAs have formed a 15-member technical committee that will now start collecting views that will lead to a referendum. Edith Kimani now looks at the three routes to a possible referendum.
Rosalind?
The plan has been set in motion for members of county assemblies to advance their referendum agenda. MCAs say they want to change the current constitution in order to protect devolution. And today, MCAs checked the first box to this plan.
Ours is only to ask Kenyans for their prayers and their support, and telling our members that as we promised, we will deliver.
The 15-member technical committee will now start collecting views that will lead to a referendum. The technical committee will also be charged with the responsibility of reaching out to Council of Governors and Opposition, CORD, with a view of drawing consensus on how to have a harmonized referendum agenda. MCAs are in good company. On Saba Saba Day, CORD mentioned a referendum as part of a 13-point resolution dubbed Okoa Kenya. In just 2 months, the Coalition for Reforms and Democracy has gone from being the Lone Ranger to one of three groups calling for a plebiscite. Pesa Mashinani, the brainchild of a section of governors, is also on the hunt for signatures to settle their referendum agenda.
We are telling them they have got to watch this space. If they don't want to accept that the solution can be found, they wataona, watakuta, wananchi wote wa Kenya wameungana, hawaelewi Jubilee, hawaelewi CORD, wanataka haki yao tu.
With the pie now split three ways, the question of exactly what these groups want changed in the constitution has become pertinent. CORD has proposed four key areas for amendment, including strengthening the current structures of devolution, a change in the electoral governing body, and a call for ethnic inclusivity and equity. Governors want pesa mashinani, or more money allocated to counties. The current constitution sets aside 15% of total national revenue to counties, and the Isaac Ruto-led team wants 45% from the coffers. Government has not taken well to these calls.
Maarufu wao na ujuzi walio nayo ni ya kutenganisha, ni ya kupangua, na ni ya kubomoa.
MCA's strident entry into the referendum pool may add pressure to a government that is already trying to play down previous calls for a ballot as untimely and selfish. This, even as all three groups hit the ground in search of backing from Kenyans. Edith Kimani, KTN.
It is indeed time for Person of Interest, and that story by Edith Kimani setting the stage for us. This morning, we're hosting the chairman of the County Assembly's Forum, that's Abdinur. He's also the County Assembly Speaker for Tana River County. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Sophia.
And also, we'll be inviting your calls to be part of this discussion. Our phone numbers will be on your screen, and you can contribute and engage with Mheshimiwa this morning. Let's begin with that story by Edith. Are you also calling for a referendum as members of the county assemblies? Are you planning for one?
Sophia, I don't know, because where this story of a referendum came in, because in our press conference yesterday, we had not mentioned even a word on referendum. But maybe reporters have a way of getting their story. But so to say, we've set up a technical committee of 15 members from among the 47 members of county assembly who were selected from their various county assemblies. And the issues that they are supposed to look at, currently everybody knows that we are facing challenges with devolution. It could be because of implementation of the constitution in some way. It could be because of some articles within the constitution that would require some little bit of fine-tuning to some extent. So the 15-member committee are going to look at the issues that are currently bedeviling devolution and many other matters that surround it, because the core of the Kenyan hope within this constitution has been that of devolution. And you'll see every article or every section within the part within the constitution mm-hmm. has in one way or another to deal with touching on matters of devolution. So the 15-member committee that's set up is going to look at matters that surround devolution and implementation of that. And they will
so
also
they're looking if there are issues.
Yeah, if there are issues, we already know.
So there are issues.
There are issues.
What issues,
know,
for example?
I would not want to go into the detail because that is for the committee to look at.
Mm-hmm.
But they will also invite the OCOA and the Pesa Mashinani referendum teams to also get to know what their grievances are and why they have gone for that route. One thing that Kenyans haven't understood is this whole issue of referendum and how it comes about. Because what OCOA Kenya team and the Council of Governors, Pesa Mashinani team, mm-hmm. are trying to do is amending the constitution through a popular initiative.
Yes.
That is likely to lead to a referendum.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the disconnect, because if everybody comes to a referendum, it's a tail end of a process.
Mm-hmm.
So what they're trying to do is looking at ways of amending the constitution through a popular initiative
mm-hmm.
that now goes through the county assemblies, that goes through parliament, and then which ends up in a referendum question at the end of it. So as of now, we cannot say as county assemblies we've decided that we're going for a referendum.
Mm-hmm.
We are only saying that we have set up a 15-member committee to look at the issues and advise the summit or the county assembly members on the way forward as to how some of these issues can be solved.
Because
it could be a referendum, it could be other means.
Because some would argue this team is perhaps to look at the goodies being dangled to the MCAs. You've seen the government is coming out and saying, yeah, here's the carrot. We have all these things we're going to give you, from the mortgage to the car grants to the working staff to the officers. And the governors as well have their own. One of the members from ODM talked about seducing. They have their own goodie bags as well. So it could be seen, some would argue, that this member committee has been set up to look at which way or which deal is sweetest from the ones coming from OCOA Kenya and Pesa Mashinani.
Sophia, I liked one cartoon that was, I can't recall which paper, I think it was The Star,
yes.
Sometimes back, where we had MCAs and we had two traps which were set up. And we were urging our members to be careful, and I think that is what we are doing. We are not going to be swayed by any goodies, because for one, what is due to county assemblies has been given to them through the constitution and through the relevant laws. So their rights they will demand, whether it is through engaging the bodies that have to deal with them,
mm-hmm.
or they have to end up in a court of law, because that is even for some of the issues
we've
done.
What rights, for instance?
And the issues that are currently being dangled in terms of how you put it.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to the issues of the fact that I think it was reported even yesterday that we've been promised by the president that they will build us offices. County assembly members are currently being given monies for offices in their wards, and we think it's their constitutional right that they must have offices.
So you don't want offices,
to work from.
You already have them.
We already have them, and,
okay.
and we're already giving them money. There was a disconnect in one way where Transitional Authority wrote letters to county governments urging mm-hmm. them to do away with offices, because according to them, they didn't think members of county assembly didn't deserve offices. But we went to court, and we got a reprieve in a way that the letter from the TA was lifted until that case is argued out in court. So we do think that what is rightfully, what rightfully belongs to members of county assemblies
cannot be dangled.
No one would deny them, and no one can dangle them.
What about the car grants?
When the county government, the governor, the Council of Governors,
mm-hmm.
are saying that in a referendum question, they would want to look at the issues of privileges for members of county assemblies, and among them would be issues of car grant to mm-hmm. county assembly members. Members of county assemblies are not naive. To be
hoodwinked
in such a way, because there is no way you are going to insert in the constitution that a member of county assembly should be given a car grant
mm-hmm.
because it wasn't there for members of parliament, but they were given, because your role as cut out within the constitution and within the relevant laws would say whether or not you are entitled to certain privileges. And we do think that for members of county assemblies and their roles as cut out, that resembles word for word that is done by members of parliament. If members of parliament were given cars, then they have right within them to demand for those car grants. So whether or not members of the Council of Governors or whoever supports that or not, we are already in court and asking that the courts, the Supreme Court gives an advisory on that. Because for one, when you look at the issues of salaries and remuneration, because that would now go in terms of benefits, that Council of Governors would think that maybe inserting a question as to whether or not members of county assembly should be given a car grant would hoodwink us. The Article 230 of the Constitution, in terms of setting out the core functions of the Salaries and Remuneration Commission, is very explicit. Mm. That they have to look, among other issues, issues of professionalism, issues of performance in terms of work, and they have to look at issues of fairness and even transparency. When you go to the Salaries and Remuneration Commission Act that was enacted by Parliament, it says in one of the clauses, in fact, from Section 12, 13 and 14 all through, it gives explicitly how they are supposed to set up salaries and remuneration. And they are told that it should be an equal pay for equal amount of work. So what is it that we would want to be put clearer than that in a constitution that does not give us our rights? Mm. So I don't think these dangles of carrots people talk about is neither here nor
so
there.
So you already have the offices. You're saying for the car grants, you're already pushing for
we're
that.
We're already pushing for it within the relevant offices.
What about for staff? You wanted extra staff members, staff, bodyguards, the personal assistants.
The staff are there. Let me say, and some of these things
each
are being portrayed.
Each of you six staff members?
Some of these things are being portrayed in a wrong way.
Okay.
And so to say, because no one has asked us to provide the number of staff that are currently supporting the members of County Assembly.
Right.
And even to say so, a minimum office in a ward would require a watchman to look after the assets of government, because there are things which belong to government.
So a watchman
and they have
is
to
one?
Look at. I just want to give you the basics.
Yes.
There has to be some sort of a secretary and a support staff. On the minimum, you would have three or four staff. So depending on
bodyguards?
We are not asking for bodyguards.
Okay.
Those were asked for long ago. Bodyguards are not paid for in any other way because they are within the police force. And when they are provided for by government, they are not earning any extra pay because they are already being paid for that
but
services.
But they are being removed from the very little numbers we have in national security to come and guard the MCA.
So to say, because even for the day when they were supposed to have been guarding borders or the like, they came to guard a rally for a court function in
So
in,
you
in
might
in
as well have
so,
them
so
as
So for
MCA.
Us, we are saying if the government thinks that the lives of members of county assembly isn't worth enough to look after, because mm-hmm. all Kenyans are supposed to be looked after. But I mean, they are one of the very important performing state officers within this country. And if the government was to look at the needs of them, and critically, we were saying even for the ones that are most deserving in terms of carving from some areas which are prone with violence and the like, or the individual members who maybe because of their push or some of the agendas within the county assemblies mm-hmm. would face some challenges in terms of security, mm-hmm. we said they'd be looked at. But that is not, they are not among the staff that are currently being paid for by county assembly county assembly service boards. But for offices, they do have.
Yes.
For staff, they do have. Mm-hmm. They are not among the carrots that should be dangled. Mm-hmm. If it comes to the car grant, we will push within the commission and tell them that they are supposed to abide by Article 230 and the act that sets them up, then they are supposed to give members of county assemblies car grant.
The other carrots
so,
being
so
dangled.
Those are not issues that will be considered in a referendum.
In a referendum.
Whether or not we should have a referendum, those are not matters for us.
No, those are not matters of referendum, but those are the issues that you're seeing the government and the Council of Governors saying they will make them happen for you so that you support scuttling the referendum for the government and supporting their push for the governors.
Sophia, so far so good. I think we've charted our way. We've shown our Kenyans that we are above board and we cannot be swayed by those goodies people talk about. And look, for instance,
isn't
even yesterday,
a matter of time
even yesterday, and I think this is and the media ought to portray whatever we are doing in terms of our efforts and support us so that Kenyans can see the difference between the current leadership within the national strata, that is the Senate, the National Assembly, and every other person who are out wrangling, and county assembly members who do things, and county assembly members who do think.
Yes.
That if it is an issue of amending the constitution, we better approach it from a bipartisan manner without looking at code, at jubilee, because issues of constitution are at the heart of every Kenyan, regardless of which party they come from. Because even the headline in The Nation yesterday, which says that I was supposed to be in Kwale cutting a deal with the president on a 12 billion dangling carrot to members of county assemblies, when indeed we were in Nairobi setting up that relevant committee, I don't think is the right way to lead this country. Let us be portrayed as to what we do. Let's not be distracted by these sideshows that they are dangling carrots from court.
Before we finish with those carrots, let's go to two more. One is that MCA has been allowed and selected to sit in for the intergovernmental, some of them the committees or institutions. Is that something you're looking to? Like one that's led by the deputy president, the intergovernmental budget and the Economic Council.
Yeah, yeah, we said so, and I must admit, Sophia, as one of the members who was in the 10th Parliament, some of these acts that are dealing with devolution were done under a lot of stress and under a lot of constraints in terms of time. And maybe because some of the challenges we are currently facing weren't foreseen. So there ought to be gaps in terms of how those acts were enacted. And when you look at these intergovernmental bodies, mm-hmm. they have got the executive in terms of representation. Now let's look, for instance, the IBEC, that is the Intergovernmental Economic and Budget Council, which is supposed to look at issues dealing with budgetary issues, any money matters that right. have to do with county governments. They are represented from the county governments by the chair of the Council of Governors, who comes from the executive side, although leading the county government, mm-hmm. and all the CECs for finance, who are now the executive committee members from the executive side again.
So you basically want to be part of.
And the assemblies are not in any way. And that is where some of these laws that are currently infringing on the independence of assemblies were being crafted and brewed. And then they are being brought as a proposal from an intergovernmental body that is supposed to be bipartisan or that's supposed to be nonpartisan. Mm-hmm. So at this juncture, we do think that the assemblies have to be represented in such a way that at least the interests so of the balance of county governments yes. are to be looked at in a bipartisan manner and not for the executive to just come and crawl and claw back.
Because that's one of the carrots, so you might yeah. just bite that one.
It's not a carrot. We do think it's a right. That that
which is being offered that to you, so you're going to take the side that's offering that.
And let's look
government?
At it. Who is supposed to offer that? Because that act has to be amended, and it has to be amended by Parliament. And Parliament
and
has,
Jubilee has the numbers.
And Parliament has both Jubilee and Court, and would look.
But Jubilee has the numbers on their side, so they will. You will
if,
have
if,
your way.
If we would look at this issue, we would yes. look at the Senate. As the house that's supposed to look at the interests of county governments, and for us to tell them that, hey, look at this, I think it is infringing on devolution. If devolution has to move, this an article has to be looked at, then that is a matter that should be approached by Code and Jubilee alike, because okay. it's a matter of interest for county governments.
The final carrot, the Ward Development Fund. Apparently you want to be able to have money that you also work with as MCAs. Is that true?
Monies are at the county governments already, so there's no money we are expecting from national government. If Ward Development
so you don't want fund, a fund
if,
set
if,
up
if,
for
if Ward Development
MCA.
Fund has to be set up, it will be set up within the confines of the laws of county government. So
do
it's
you
nothing,
want it to be set up?
Many counties have already set up the county development funds. They are already in place. The only hiccup has come in a situation where they are saying maybe members of county assemblies, having come from the assembly side, should not be involved in the executive function in terms of executing functions like Ward Development Fund. But we are likely saying, if you believe that members of county assemblies should not be involved in development issues and that Ward Development Fund should be done away with, then so should the CDF. So we are saying if the law applies, let it apply across the board.
So you want to be like MPs?
Yeah. It's not that we want to
it's
be
a
like
supremacy,
MPs.
It's a supremacy, because they're saying no, if MPs have it, why don't we have
it? We are not saying so, but we are saying that the functions as cut out for Parliament and for county assemblies are similar. So if the laws have to apply, they have to apply across the board. It's not about supremacy, but it's about levelness in terms of within the law.
So you want the
Ward We are not saying we want the Ward Development Fund have been established in a number of counties, yes. including Nairobi County Assembly, Nairobi County Government. Mm-hmm. So it's not a carrot that should be dangled, because county assemblies and county governments have already gone ahead to establish Ward Development Funds in various counties.
So I'm hearing you explaining very hard these carrots are not in any way
enticing
the MCAs.
They're not there. They're not
but
there.
That you've set up your committee to be able to look at the issues. We're going to continue with this discussion after the break and get into the merits and demerits perhaps of some of the issues that are being raised from both sides, and what perhaps in your discussion that you had a conference at Bomas weeks ago to deliberate on which side you'd support, that I guess led to this steering committee
sure.
to help you with aligning yourselves to which side or charting your own way forward.